This is part 16 of Azure tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss Azure Just-in-Time VM Access feature. So, what is Just-in-Time Virtual Machine Access? Well, hackers always scan the internet for open ports like RDP or SSH. If you have a port open all the time, it's a potential target for an attack. When one of the VMs in your network is breached, it can be used as the entry point to attack other servers and resources within your environment. Just-in-time VM access reduces the attack surface area by opening the inbound ports just when you need them and are automatically closed after the specified duration has elapsed. So, how to enable just-in-time VM access? Well, there are two ways. We can either enable it from the virtual machine itself or from Azure Security Center. Here is the virtual machine that we created in our previous video, vm-presumtech. Let's navigate to this virtual machine and then get to the networking blade. Notice we have an inbound port rule here. We created this rule in our previous video. Basically, we open this port 3389 for RDP communication. The problem with this inbound port rule is this port is always open, and the moment attackers see that this port is open, it can be used as a potential target for an attack. And once a VM within your network is breached, it can be used as an entry point to attack further resources within your environment. Now, let's navigate to the connect blade and notice the message that we have here. To improve security, enable just-in-time access on this VM. We'll get to this in just a bit. First, let's download the RDP file and then remotely log into our virtual machine in Azure. There we go. We are able to successfully log in. Now, let's disconnect and get back to Azure portal. Before we enable just-in-time access on this VM, let's go to the networking blade once and pay attention to the priority of this inbound port rule. At the moment, it is 100. Now let's see what's going to happen after we enable JIT VM access. So let's go to the Connect tab and then click this link, Enable Just-in-Time Access on this VM. What it does is navigates us to the configuration blade. And on this blade, we have this button, Enable Just-in-Time. So this is one of the ways if you want to enable Just-in-Time VM access. You go to the virtual machine itself, click on the configuration blade, and there you have it, Enable Just-in-Time. So let's click this button. There we go. Just-in-Time VM access is successfully enabled. Now, let's go back to the networking blade. Notice we have a new inbound rule here. And notice the name of this rule, Security Center JIT rule. So by looking at this name, we can be sure this rule is automatically added by Azure when we enabled just-in-time VM access. And what it's doing, basically, it's denying access to this port 3389 from any source and from any protocol. And look at the destination here, the IP address 10.0.0.4. Basically, if you take a VM in Azure, it has two IP addresses. One is private IP address and the other one is public IP address. We use the public IP address to communicate with this EVM from the internet, and private IP address stays private within the Azure network. So basically what we see here is the private IP address. Basically, this rule here, which is added by Azure automatically when we enabled just-in-time VM access, blocks the incoming traffic to this port number 3389. And here's the interesting bit. Look at the priority. The priority for this rule is 1000. And here is the rule that we added in our previous video. Notice the priority of this rule is now adjusted to be a higher number than this rule. So basically, rules with lower priority win. That means this deny rule will win over the allow rule. So if we try to connect to our VM using RDP right now, it should fail. So let's try that. Let's launch the RDP client. So go to the run window, type MSTSC, click OK. To RDP into our virtual machine, we need to use this public IP address 20.55. .8.53 : the port number 3389. So let's click connect. It's trying to remotely connect to our virtual machine in Azure. Let's give it a few seconds and see what's going to happen. Eventually, it should fail with an error. There we go, remote desktop connection error. At the moment, I'm not able to remotely connect to our virtual machine in Azure, but I want to connect to it now. So how do I do it? Well, we have to request access, and we can do that in two ways. One is from the Connect tab. So here, we have this button here, Request Access, or we can do it from Azure Security Center. We have a link for Azure Security Center on the configuration blade. When we click this link, it takes us to Azure Security Center. So here we have our VM. Notice at the moment we are on the Configure tab, and to request access, click this button, Request Access. Here is the interesting bit. We are basically requesting this port 3389 to be opened for RDP communication. At the moment, it's off. We want to turn it on. And how do we want to connect to this VM? Now, when I select my IP, basically it's going to use the IP address of my laptop, which I have used to log into Azure portal. This means I can only remotely connect from my laptop. Now, we can also specify IP range, that is multiple IP addresses. Maybe, for example, we want to grant access, you know, to myself as well as to two other colleagues of mine. I can specify multiple IP addresses if I want to, or a range of IP addresses. And then finally, the duration for how long we want this port to be open. Maybe we want it to be open for just 1 hour. So let's adjust the time. And then optionally, we can also enter the justification for why we are opening this port. And then click this button, Open Ports. There we go. Our request is approved. And we can edit this again if we want to. For that, click on this ellipsis button and then edit. Once we click on this request here, we see the interface to edit it. Now, if you look at the duration, I remember I have specified 1 hour. Maybe I didn't save it. That's why we still see the default 3 hours. Let's change it to 1 and then click OK. So now it is 1 hour. Let's save it. Go back to our VM and let's take a look at the inbound port rules. We have a new inbound port rule. So basically to this port 3389, we have an allow rule. And look at the priority number of this rule. It is 100, less than this deny rule. So this allow rule is going to win, meaning we will have access now to our VM. Let's try that. Enter the password. There we go. We are now remotely connected and logged in. Here's the important bit to keep in mind. When we requested access to this VM, we specified the duration as 1 hour. Now, what do you think is going to happen to this inbound port rule after that 1 hour has elapsed? Well, this rule will be automatically deleted and will not have access. And that's a good thing. So, just-in-time VM access reduces the attack surface area by opening the inbound ports just when you need them and are automatically closed after the specified duration has elapsed. So with JIT VM access, we can configure the following three things. Which port you want to open? In our case, it is 3389 for RDP communication. From which IP address you want to allow access? You can also specify a range if you want to. And finally, the duration in hours for which you want this port to be open. After that specified duration has expired, the corresponding inbound port role is automatically deleted and you will not have access. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.